So, hello everyone. I am Yogesh Yadav. It's my pleasure to introduce myself as being part of Creators Garage Club at the North Cape University. And we are back again with another yet exciting webinar. Today's topic of the hour is how to get started with open source projects and an introduction to Git and GitHub. Like, as you all know, all major tech companies uses GitHub for at least some of their open source projects. And that's why it is one of the important industry skills required nowadays. So with it, it's lots of application and knowledge. Ladies and gentlemen, it's an absolute honor for me to Mr. Gaurav Sharma as our keynote speaker for our exclusive event. He is a Red Hat certified architect, level 17, and with a lot of corporate managing skills. With all that, I would like to thank all attendees for joining. We will also be keeping a session just after this show. Make sure you drop your doubts in the chat box, and during the session we will take them towards the end. The platform is all yours, sir. Once again, I welcome you and please begin.
Thank you so much, Yogesh, for that wonderful intro. And definitely, I'll try to make it the best I can. And first of all, let me tell you, this is the 19th call I'm having right now. And seeing this graphic again motivated me that I can speak up for another like 2 to 3 hours, and I can be here for like hours and hours with you. Thank you so much. Whosoever has created, do guys share me that GIF. I would love to keep it with myself handy. And whenever I feel demotivated, I can stay motivated. Okay. So good evening, everyone, and thank you so much for being here with us.
Absolutely.
I can share the screen. Okay. So before I share the screen, I can see a lot of people on the tiles. Hey guys, can you turn on your cameras so that I can see that I'm not the only one who is looking so bad and frustrated after the entire day? Oh my God, at least few of the people can turn on the cameras if it permits to you, if you're in a good state, or at least I know a few people, Arub, Yogesh, Munish, you on my stocks, keep your cameras on. Oh my God, Yogesh sir, thank you so much for turning on the camera. Arup, buddy, thank you so
Of
much.
course, sir.
Munish, Yogesh, Rishabh, I can see. Okay, I'm not talking to the tiles. Rohan, ग्रेट. देखो यार, सबके शक्ल हमारे एक जैसे हो रखे हैं. गेम खेल करके ऐसे नहीं हम लोग करेंगे. योगेश सर बहुत अच्छी इंग्लिश बोलते हैं. गाइज, एक्सक्यूज मी इफ आई एम नॉट एबल टू प्रेजेंट यू सम गुड इंग्लिश स्टफ आउट देयर. ओके, सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल, आई वांट टू किक अप दिस सेशन बाय not forgetting our Creators Garage team for giving me this opportunity to present my views on, let's say, the open source and Git. But before I talk about it's the evening time, let's play some game, man. So I want three volunteers. You can turn on your camera, and if you are able to see the screen, can I get the three name, please? Or I'll give the opportunity to Yogesh. Yogesh, one is definitely you. So,
Of course, sir.
who are gonna be
Yeah.
joining us? The another people. Can I hear the names, please?
Arup, you wanna try out?
Yeah, I'm there. I'm
Arup
obviously there.
is there. Yogesh is there. The third one is
Me?
me. Who is this me?
My name is me.
Manish. Okay. Oh, sorry, 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 bhai. Aapka naam miss hua. I am so sorry, Manish. Okay. Out of all three of you, at this point of time, just imagine, close your eyes and no, not close your eyes, your guide might get sleep. I want to say that if imagine yourself in a situation that I'm going to reward you with something, but the only condition it that thing that I'm going to give it to you right now, you can choose anything, whatever the price, whatever the model, whatever the color is going to be. The thing is, you cannot change that particular materialistic thing for the entire rest of your life. You cannot do it, means you don't have any option. So you three, you choose the sequence. The very first gift is the bike, means you name the bike on the planet and you can get it, the color, the configuration, or XYZ things. I'm gonna take the question for you. Manish, Arup, Yogesh, anybody interested in bike?
Yeah, I'll take the bike.
So who is I?
It's
Manish?
Arup.
Arup. So Arup, you are assigned with a bike.
Okay.
Who's gonna take the car? Swaroop, now you're out of the game, man.
No issues. I'm happy with the bike.
So who's this? Yogesh?
Yeah, let's bring the
Yogesh. Guns. You got the car for sure. And Munish, man, look, the two people kicked you out, but I have a plane for you.
Okay.
Sure. You rightly said that if something is not working according to your plan, if something God planned. So, bhai, there is a private jet available. Now, my quick question to you is, Arup has a bike, Yogesh has a car, and Munish has a plane. Now, condition is, you have to ride this vehicle for the entire rest of your life. Means you cannot change it. Whatever the thing you wish to do it with this, you have to do this thing. Now, how you're going to make this thing happen? Can someone tell me? मतलब आइडिया क्या है यही बाइक तुम्हें या कार या प्लेन तुम्हें पूरी लाइफ लॉन्ग चलानी है यू कैन नॉट चेंज इट दिस इज द ओनली ऑप्शन यू हैव सो हाउ यू आर गोइंग टू सर्वाइव विद दिस या योर व्यूज प्लीज
इफ इट्स माय केस इन केस ऑफ बाइक सो आई गेस अपग्रेडेशन वुड बी वन ऑप्शन बिकॉज़ विद टाइम यू नीड टू अपग्रेड सो
या अपग्रेडेशन यस बट यू हैव टू अपग्रेड दिस व्हीकल ओनली राइट
या या
लेट मी मेक इट क्लियर ओके Yogesh, anything from your side, please?
I think if it's my favorite car, then I will be like more towards it and I will not have such issues like changing it or upgrading it. But upgradation is also one of the points.
But this is going to be your favorite car, whichever you dream for. This is the car. What is the precaution that you will take, Yogesh, with this car?
I will try to save with it. I will try to use it accordingly and for the betterment only.
Yes.
And you know, it will be fun because it's my favorite. So it will be every time exciting and new thing for me. Just opening it again and again and again.
Absolutely, absolutely correct. What about you, my friend Munish? You get the most expensive one, huh? Right. It can make the ease of your life accessibility.
Yeah.
If I'm getting it right.
Yeah.
Right. And do you think that all three of you, do you agree that if somebody asks you that, hey, I want your bike, I want your car, I want your plane, can you let it go?
No.
All three of you agree, right?
Yeah, unless it's for a very good reason.
Might. But still, 1% डर तो रहता ही है हमारे दिल में कि यार, if somebody else is gonna drive it, might should not happen wrong. Now, just close your eyes and think in this way. You are your own product. Your mother, father has given this world a unique product. Hey, I'm getting a lot of background noise. Is it from my end?
No.
Okay. Oh, sorry. So what I want to request you all is just close your eyes for a moment and dream that your mom and dad has given this wonderful product to this world by the name of yours. Means like, if I have to imagine my mom and dad has given this one Gaurav Sharma to the world, how the hell anybody else can drive this? I have to upgrade to make my life worthy. I have to play it very safe whenever it comes to choosing an opportunity. I have to make sure that when the ease of access comes, I better use it to full max. You all are your product of your imagination. Just think in this way, that you are your own car, your bike and plane. Nobody else should control it. Whenever the time comes, you need to upgrade it. And upgradation can only happen by taking the suggestions. You have to make the best out of it, the opportunity you have got. You have to choose the opportunity wisely so that you can make it best. Right? Isn't it worthy?
Yes, it is.
Just if you open up your eyes, I hope everybody can easily understand the quorum that if you are here, you have choose this opportunity, make it best out of it. You are upgrading yourself. This is the one life that you are blessed of. Don't let the control of your life go into somebody else's hand. Right? And that's where the most important question comes. open source. Be open-minded means be honest to your work. And more important, when it comes to the technical side, open source is very wrongly adapted in the market. And when we say open source is wrongly adapted, that means open source is something that everybody says that it is freely available. It is like for the community, anybody can copy the code and they can contribute to it. Hey, there is a lot more than that happening. So that's what we are going to talk about, that when and where this open source came into the world, how anybody can contribute to it. Moreover, what are the different ways to get started with the contribution and who all can contribute to this world of open source. So let me get on the very first point called open source. Anybody want to say what is the open source? Hope my screen is visible, Arup, right?
Yeah, your screen is visible, absolutely.
Awesome. So can anybody tell me what is open source?
Anyone from the audience can.
Yeah, please feel free to unmute and just, yeah.
Yeah, as you said earlier, which is accessible, easily accessible, because it is open source.
Yes. Or,
matlab, ye costly nahi hoti hai.
और कॉस्टली नहीं होने से मतलब है फ्री होती है या कुछ नॉमिनल कॉस्ट होती है?
कुछ रूल्स होते हैं, अब जैसे हमने ओपन सोर्स रेड हैट की बात की, मतलब यूज तो कर सकते हैं पर कुछ जो वर्जन्स होते हैं, अब जैसे हमने यूनिक्स ले लिया,
हां
कुछ पेड करना होगा क्योंकि वो हर किसी के लिए नहीं है.
हर किसी के लिए नहीं है, बहुत अच्छी बात कही. हु इज दिस मैन?
अनिरुद्ध.
Anirudh, great explanation, buddy. You just talked about the right bang on point. Open source is not absolutely free. It totally depends on the product. Now, I want to clear one perspective over here, and this history can be read over here. There are two words associated with open source softwares and free open source software. Let's take a very simple example. I was actually feeling hungry, so I took this example, water. Do you think water is an open source?
Yes, definitely.
Definitely. किसी भगवान का कोई ठप्पा नहीं लगा हुआ, कोई तुम्हें रोकता नहीं है पानी में जाकर के जो करना चाहो वो कर सकते हो. Are you paying for the water?
Mm-hmm.
You pay for claiming the water. यार बिस्लेरी एक्वाफिना, देख झूठ बोल दिया यार आपने अभी.
Pay कर रहे हैं, कर रहे हैं, pay.
हाँ, कर भी रहे हो.
वो तो फिर कुछ केसेस में होता है ना.
हाँ, यही बात है ओपन सोर्स के साथ. यस यस, दिस इज द राइट पॉइंट व्हिच आई वांट टू ब्रिंग ऑन. नाउ टेक दिस एग्जांपल फ्रॉम माय लाइक प्रेजेंटेशन. अगर दुनिया में कोई तुमसे पूछे कि यार ओपन सोर्स क्या है और व्हाट इज दिस ओपन सोर्स इज ऑल अबाउट, टेक दिस एग्जांपल इन फ्रंट ऑफ देम. हे लुक, वाटर इज अ यूनिवर्सल लाइक ओपन सोर्स प्रोडक्ट दैट यू फाइंड इट अराउंड. कोई भगवान का ठप्पा नहीं है, किसी के पास कोई लिमिट नहीं है कि तुम इतना यूज कर सकते हो, बट यू कैन इंजीनियर दैट वाटर टू मेक द बेस्ट आउट ऑफ इट, और आई शुड से मेक द प्रोडक्ट आउट ऑफ इट और योर ओन ब्रांड आउट ऑफ इट. दैट व्हाट द बिस्लेरी एक्वाफिना इवान एक्स वाई जी कंपनी डज इट, राइट? दे इंजीनियर द प्रोडक्ट. व्हाई दे आर एबल टू इंजीनियर? बिकॉज द सोर्स कोड इज फ्री. गंगोत्री से पानी आ रहा है, कोई ग्लेशियर से पानी निकल रहा है, दे प्रिजर्व दैट वाटर, दे इंजीनियर, दे मिक्स सम ऑफ द मिनरल्स एंड एक्स वाई जी थिंग्स इनटू इट, एंड हे यू हैव एन प्रोडक्ट. नाउ इट टोटली डिपेंड्स ऑन मी वेदर आई वांट टू मेक इट पब्लिक व्हिच इज फ्रीली अवेलेबल और वेदर आई वांट टू मेक इट लाइक प्रोडक्टेबिलिटी आउट ऑफ इट और आई वांट टू अटैच अ बिजनेस सेंस टू इट. सो द open source software has the business mentality and free open source software is freely code that is accessible to the public. When it comes to Red Hat, Anirudh, my friend, you have just taken the right crux of it. Yes, you can use all the Red Hat products free of cost. Can you modify it? No. You have to go to the upstream product of that. Like Red Hat Enterprise Linux has the upstream project Fedora. So you can copy the code of Fedora. You can contribute to Fedora. Can you contribute to Red Hat? No. You have to pay for Red Hat? Yes. You are paying for the support that you are getting because you are getting an enterprise product. नदी से पानी आ रहा है, तुम पी लोगे, कोई गारंटी थोड़ी ना लेगा कि वो पानी जहरीला है या नहीं है. बट अगर तुम एक्वाफिना या बिस्लरी से पानी पी रहे हो, यू आर गेटिंग अ राइट पॉइंट ऑफ कॉन्टेक्ट दैट हे ये हियर आई कैन क्लेम इट. सो दिस इज हाउ द ओपन सोर्स केम इन. And I believe many of you might have heard this or just do visit this link called opensource.org/history. In 1990s, this boom came out of the open source world that let's hear the ideas from other. And this is what the open source actually means. Hearing the ideas of different like-minded people, they present their views, they give the best of best what they want to do, and this is how they take the conversation ahead. So do visit this link for the entire history, and I don't want to keep on the history part. I'd rather want to get started. So where to get start from? Very important to understand. I just explained a funda. Let's talk about the technical term which you guys are able to digest. Let's say I'm a developer. I created a code base. I share the source code to the entire world to get the better feedback. But I kept the compiled program to myself. This is what happens in case of Bisleri. Bisleri ne pani ka formula to sabko nahi diya hai. Pani sabke paas abhi bhi available chhod rakha hai. So this compiled program is my own identity, but this I can share the source code. Different people collaborate, they improve the source code, and they just simply contribute to the vastly code base. So where to get this code base from? So there are a lot of like variety of tools which are available in the market to grab the source code from. Like Git is there, CVS is there, Apache, Subversion is there, which is popularly called SVN, Mercurial, Monoton, Bazaar, XYZ. These all are typically called as version control system. And towards the end, I'm definitely gonna jump onto some of these things where we can discuss more in detail that what are these things are all about. Okay, so that is one thing. Now, if you see ahead, why I'm talking about, thing is, somewhere down the line, I need to grab the source code. Now, this source code, which is being shared by this developer, I need some pointing tool to grab it. I cannot go and ask, hey, Bhagwan ke naam pe kuch de de. Bhagwan upar se aakar ke thodi na denge. I have to be a human reachable approach. So there are a lot of free websites where you go. And one of the most popular version control system is called Git. And I'm going to ask you the question, do open up your Google and everybody shout it out that who gave us this beautiful concept of Git and what was the reason behind it. I'll be more than happy to hear that reason also. And towards the end, I'm definitely going to give it. So these are the ways to get started. Means first of all, search the code base, clone it, discover it, learn from it, and then start working towards it. So there are a lot of open source contests from where you get these links. I believe you can take the screenshots, or I believe I can share down this my entire deck with the let's say Yogesh, Arup, and Munish, or XYZ people from the Creators Garage, and they can share it to you, or you can reach out to them or to me. I'll share my coordinates wherever you can reach out to me, and I can share down these. Now, these programs, what the beauty of these programs is, they invite a lot of projects. You get an idea that what is industry is doing. What are the use cases that industry is trying to solve? You connect with like-minded people, because this is very much important to understand that you cannot bring the change on your own. Definitely you can, but add some time, you need certain time to go ahead and bring this change happen, right? Because if you see that, hey, I have an idea where to get start from, you definitely need a mentor. Like take an example, you want to get start with open source. So Creator Garage has given you this platform to explore something. You pick up some of the names out of here. Let's take an example of GSoC, which is the most popular one. But half of the people don't know, apart from Google Summer of Code, there are a whole bunch of programs which are available. Though yes, few of them are outdated. GirlScript Summer of Code is going live. Red Hat Open Source Contest is the specific contest that runs for women out there who wants to contribute to open source. There is a Force Asia internship program. There are Linux Foundation programs that are going on. There is a specific program for designers who wants to contribute. There are a lot of programs that are running in the open source world. Just go and start searching about these programs. Put it on the Google and you can get the names out of it. And if you're still, just reach out to me. I can definitely help you with some of them. Now, objective of these open source program is to introduce the projects. Key, where you can get the starting point, where you can understand. Okay, now I know the door that, hey, here is the opportunity. I need to knock it up. Then how it is easy to get started? This is the very important question that I keep on hearing from the people. Always try to search beginner issues. So what happened in the open source world is, whenever I launch a project, I keep on mentioning these keywords like beginner issue or my first issue, something similar to these. Go and start searching about these keywords into your project So basically, these are also called as tags. So what happens if I upload any, let's say, project, you will get this keyword so that you understand that I'm looking for the beginner friendly people. But I should say, I want a person who is very beginner. And if you still don't have that confidence that, hey, I'm very much new, these two websites I want to recommend to you, which is called Up for Grabs. And second is issuehub.io. Just go and Google Up for Grabs and the Issue Hub. These are the two very beginner friendly like websites. Just go explore the open source projects. They are like 12 months, 24/7 available websites. People keep on putting the things. Idea to redirect you all to these websites is to understand that how the contribution gets started. You can read the entire documentation. They gives you the guideline. And more important, they also give you that what the project that is running locally, who is the project maintainer, how I can leave the message to that particular task, how I can exit, how I can tag that person, how you can, I can do the networking, and more important, get to work. According to your expertise of keywords, they have defined the tags. Like if I'm good in DSA, I can search for DSA and you can get over there. I'm good in understanding JavaScript. You can go and talk about JavaScript. I'm good in writing. Go to documentation. I'm good in design. Go to the design part. And everything is there on your plate. So these are the two websites I highly recommend for the beginners or for the first year students, or even for the person who just want to get started with the contribution journey. One is Up for Grabs and second is issuehub.io. So these are the two websites. Do take the screenshots or reach it out to me later on, or if Yogesh or Arup is there. Guys, do text these websites in the chat box so that everybody can simply get it up from there.
Yeah.
Now, sure. You know the door. This is the very first ladder that you are climbing up. What's next? Now, there are many different ways to contribute to the project. The very famous way is create your own project and get started. But hey, sir, you just talked about, first of all, main kaise kar lu? Main to abhi start hi kar raha hu. Definitely, the second point is about contribute to the existing open source project and best get back to your open source project itself. Because what happens is when you try to see somebody else's project, you get an idea, you get an influence. And that's what I'm trying to build to you, that how easy it is to contribute to open source. You get the crux. You understand that what is the requirement that industry is looking for. You follow the trend that, okay, these are the things that is being experienced in the industry already. And at it, you create a think might create a revolution, or at least you want to hear somebody else's feedback. Tag your friends, ask their reviews, and that's where you get start with your own projects also, and you can make others contribute to the same. Wo bada famous video hai YouTube pe ki agar jab aap open source search karoge na, there is a cake video. Okay, maine cake banaya, somebody put it down that icing, somebody put it down the cherry or XYZ things. And that's how you keep on getting the new feedback. So that's how the things go. Contribute to the existing source. Provide feedback. At least agar kuch bhi nahi kar sakte ho, to uska code base samajh ke uske liye document likh do. Uske liye beautiful design suggest kar do. Suggest some of the changes. Present the idea that you think of. And then if you are good to go, do it. Which I personally believe, create the open source alternative to the commercial software. What happens, I believe many of you during this pandemic would have discovered this part, that when this ban of the China's product, or I should say China app, happened, there were a lot of emerging technology that came out, or the products that came out. What they did, they created an alternative of those application. Like one of the famous was TikTok got banned and Instagram Reels came out. Or similar thing, I believe, I don't know how many of you followed it or not, the JL stream, Jaldi live stream app by Raj Kundra. He produced in a fashion of Made in India. And that was the alternative to the commercial software, because there was a lot of buzz around that Zoom might get banned, or some streaming application of in-house India, the StreamYard, or XYZ alternatives to that. So once you are efficient, try to create the open source alternative of the commercial software so that you can attract the audience to your platform. And then if you want to make it commercialized, it's totally up to you, because you hold the entire right to it. Now, very important, when you want to get started, clone the project, develop your own. This is what the source code open means to you. Like if you want to create your own Linux platform, you can get the code base of Fedora, get it, change the logo and make it Gaurav, make it Arup, make it Yogesh, make it Munish, anything that you wish to, because that's the important. Clone the project. Don't make the pull request to the existing part. And what I mean by the, I would say the pull request, I'm going to talk in the Git section, but yes, this is what I want to make. Don't make the change in the master branch. Reason being, it is very difficult for me because I have made it open. Somebody maliciously plant a vulnerability threat over there. And that is the biggest challenge for me. And that's where I can get the credibility or the accountability or the access and the advocacy of my customer. Or I should say all the contributors. So to create the healthy environment, you should clone the projects, test at your own local environment, and then start developing your own, pull down the bugs and XYZ things happen soon. Okay, now I know the door. I know the first step, how I can climb the next ladders. I know. More important, how do I contribute to the project? This is also important that while understanding the open source thing, everybody sees one thing only, that I can contribute just by coding. Absolutely no. Even if you ask me, I am not a good coder at all, but I can help you in understanding the documentation. I write the documentation. I provide the bug reports and fixes. I help in doing the research activities. I can help you to design the things. And more important, as if you ask me, and I claim myself as an open source enthusiast, which basically means I am the person who helps to spread the words. Like Creator Garage is also doing an open source community building activity. This is what they are spreading the words that, hey, this is the open source world. Anybody can come join and collaborate and present their ideas. So these are some of the different ways to contribute apart from doing the coding. That if you feel that you are not good in coding, mereko coding nahi aati hai, main still contributor banna chahta hun, yes, you can help us in creating the documentation. English likhna jante ho, English mein likho. Hindi likhna jante ho, aajkal bahut sare documentation ke projects aate hain where you can contribute as an like a linguist, which you can create the documentation in your regional language. Also, the bug reports and fixes, bahut important hai to discover the bugs. मैंने एक एप्लीकेशन लॉन्च करी, अब मुझे टेस्ट करना है मैं कैसे करूं, मैं इसको ओपन सोर्स रख देता हूं, एवरीबॉडी विल यूज, एंड हर किसी को यूज करने का अपना तरीका होगा, तो आई विल गेट मोर आइडियाज आउट ऑफ इट. सो कीप एक्सप्लोरिंग द डिफरेंट वेज, ऑलवेज रिलेटेड टू कोडिंग, दीज आर दी ऑल्सो डिफरेंट वेज दैट यू कैन कॉन्ट्रीब्यूट टू ओपन सोर्स एज एन इंडिविजुअल. यू कैन राइट द डॉक्यूमेंटेशन, यू कैन क्रिएट द बग रिपोर्ट्स, यू कैन हेल्प इन द बग फिक्सेस, यू कैन डिजाइन इट, यू कैन रिसर्च इट, यू कैन बी अ क्वालिटी एनालिस्ट, यू कैन बी अ क्वालिटी इंजीनियर, एंड मोर इंपॉर्टेंट, यू कैन बी एन ओपन सोर्स एडवोकेट हु हेल्प इन स्प्रेडिंग द वर्ड ऑफ द कम्युनिटी. Okay, so these are the different ways that you can be as a contributor. You can play a key role into the contribution part. Now, who all can contribute? I hope now you understand. Anybody can contribute. It is just to be open, to share the things and learn. You should have that. And always remember that if you want to be an open source contributor, it's not about the competition. It's all about the collaboration. क्योंकि कंपटीशन आप करने जाओगे ना, आप सबसे फाइट करने में लग जाओगे. और ओपन सोर्स इज नॉट अबाउट फाइटिंग विद ईच अदर, इट्स ऑल अबाउट शेयरिंग अ हेल्दी एनवायरनमेंट, इट्स अबाउट एक्सेप्टिंग द आइडियाज फ्रॉम अदर्स. मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट पार्ट है ये ओपन सोर्स को अगर करना है. देन कैन समवन टेल मी, व्हेन यू वांट टू कॉन्ट्रीब्यूट देर आर सर्टन गाइडलाइंस और रूल्स, व्हाट इज दिस थिंग कॉल्ड etiquettes in terms of open source. Anybody have heard this term called open source etiquettes? Ma'am, akela hu kya yahan pe sab? What do you think? What is the open source etiquettes are all about? So let me tell you, like, take an example. I was just having a gulp of water. Now, what does this mean? For drinking this water, from this bottle, the lid was closed. First of all, it was placed on my table. I pulled it up, I opened the cap, and I sip it. I have opened up to sip kar lete. So now I have to put it back again and keep it on again on the stable environment to make it stable. Similar thing, when you are going for an open source contribution or when you want to be an active contributor, what do you have to make sure? There are some list of etiquettes that you should follow while you claim yourself to be a contributor. Very first one is, if there is a documentation, read it. 100%, if there is an open source project which is there, there will be a lot of guidelines that are being mentioned. Do read those guidelines. It is very important. Terms and condition, padho ya na padho, jisko hum padhe bina, please, I accept all, pe click kar dete hain. That is fine. But while you are going to contribute to any project, there will be whole bunch of documentation, or I should say guideline, which is available. Read them up. Now, you are got an issue, or I should say you got a bug, or you got a test that, hey, this is something I want to report. Bring it up. Look for the similar issue of that project. Is that issue, or like, was it being reported by somebody else? Check it out. Might somebody else is already working on it and they have given their views to it. So you can put down your views rather than opening a new issue of it. If you didn't find it, it's okay to open it up. Now, while opening, make sure the third point, provide as much as info you can possible when you're reporting a bug or an issue. As a project maintainer, things that you have already tried to check it out, or how you have checked to find this bug, so that my time is saved. And you said outer. Does this make sense? I have to make sure that a bowler bowled, the batsman hit, and outer. Catch out bhi ho sakta hai, bold bhi ho sakta hai, LBW bhi ho sakta hai, stump bhi ho sakta hai, run out bhi ho sakta hai. I have to describe the entire scenario, right? So that's the important part, that if you find a bug or an issue, provide as much as info you can. Then always like follow the guidelines and whatever the, it has mentioned, that some of the specific project require a certain way to describe your like guidelines or the reporting way. Somebody accept the Bugzilla, somebody expect the XYZ channels, follow them, do join the Discords, do join the Slack channels or the Telegram groups, whatever they define. More important, be empathetic and understanding. Why? Because what I have observed, let's take an example of LinkedIn. People will text me and they are expecting an immediate revert. In the presentation, how you're expecting me to revert at the same time on LinkedIn? It takes time. So be understanding that if you have reported a bug on fourth or fifth day, revert with a simple quote that, hey, Gaurav, I haven't heard it from you. Can you please look into it, or have you find some time to look into it? After 4 to 5 days, if they didn't revert, tag it back again. If it is happening third, fourth time, do reach out to them over a different channel that, hey, I have reported this bug, are you active on it? If somebody is not there, if somebody has already commented, do try to reach out to them. So be empathetic and understanding. It's all about like collaborating and being in the corporate world, because everybody has their own flexible lifestyle and everybody is contributing because of their willingness. Then once the address is the issue or the bug is being addressed, always be thankful. And that's how it shows that you are the consistent learner. That is the most important part. So say thank you, acknowledge the thing that you have heard of. Okay, so that is the most important part. And these are some of the open source etiquettes that everybody should follow while keeping in the mind that you are contributing to the open source world. Okay. Now, before I jump onto the present scene, I want to take a moment and pause that. Is there something that is there in the chat for me? Any questions? Arup, can I have something? Is there something?
Yeah, I think there are some questions. Can you?
So do you want me to check it right now or towards the end?
I think we'll take it at the end, I guess.
Okay, sure, no problem. I just thought of like pausing for a bit and just want to check. Okay, no problem. So what I want to give you all is the company perspective, or I should say that my industry experience, what I have observed in the industry, that how the things are happening in the present scenario. Now, most of the people understand that everybody is looking for their journey to happening in the cloud. Now, the most important part is there are legacy softwares which are existing in the industry. अगर तुम बीटेक फोर्थ ईयर के अंदर हो और कोई कंपनी तुम्हें हायर करना चाहती है तो ये चीज दिमाग में डाल लेना और लाइक पुट दिस थिंग इन योर हेड दैट कंपनी इज ऑलरेडी हैविंग सम सॉफ्टवेयर और प्रोडक्ट ऑफ देयर ओन दे वांट टू हायर यू टू इम्प्रूव देयर प्रोडक्ट बहुत कम चांसेस होंगे जब तुम्हें हायर किया जाएगा व्हेन द प्रोडक्ट दे आर एक्सपेक्टिंग यू टू क्रिएट द प्रोडक्ट और यू क्लेम टू बी अ डिसीजन मेकर इन दैट प्रोडक्ट Understand that there is a legacy product which is happening in the industry. Now, maine yaar Dragon ki condition liya, which is a legacy software. Now, what is happening? There are a lot of other people who are cloud architects, system administrator, DBA, which is a database, projects manager, senior developers, XYZ. They try to control the product in their own ways. Why? Because they don't know the understanding of the power of collaboration. Ye bichare open source world se nahi aaye the. They were like looking for the people who were just expert in one particular domain. And they started treating that software as that individual identity, which ultimately leads to the frustration and all the amalgamation that are happening in the industry, that it is not transparent. Everybody is not vocal about the products. And most important thing is the software is getting trouble. They keep on hiring and the customer suffers. So first of all, understand the power of collaboration is the most important thing in the industry. So the enterprise journey to the cloud, or when I say cloud, it is all about the digitization. And when I say digital transformation happening in any industry, it cannot only happen just by adopting the digital technology. It platform need to automate, its processes need to be more agile, and more important, the people. So three P's for the digital transformation is process, platform, and the people. The right skill set people need to be there. I'll give you a very simple example. I hope many of you like to play cricket. Hey, Arup, my friend, can you help me in understanding for everybody's? If I'll ask you, Arup, do you like cricket?
Yes.
If I'll give you an opportunity to play for India team, would you mind accepting or rejecting it?
Yes, I would.
I would. And if I'll ask you what you're going to do in cricket to get claimed to be as a Indian cricketer or something?
I guess that qualification to be a cricketer on that level.
Then what is the key aspects that a cricketer would be looking? Like taking an example, batting, or do you want to add some more terms to it?
Batting, bowling, fielding, all that.
All that. Do you claim yourself to be a cricketer if you only know batting?
No.
Similar, the answer goes to the open source contributor. If you just know the C, it is not going to help you in getting the successful job. You have to be the master of every single thing, or not even at least the master, the learner of every single thing. Arup rightly said, if I get an opportunity to get selected in India team, definitely I'll say opportunity to yes. But do you claim yourself to be a cricketer to accept it that there is an opportunity? I cannot claim myself a cricketer if I only know batting or bowling. Yaar, fielding mujhe nahi karni, uske liye niche jhukna padta hai, apne se to batting kara lo. Samne wala bhi kahega, sir, wo ra rasta aur aap chale jao. That what happens in the interview, that you keep on emphasizing only on marks or only on that tree diagram that you have learned via C++. Today, the person is searched in such a way that they are claimed to be the leaders, because leadership is not about the position. Leadership is about the actions that you take. So over here, this legacy software is happening because these people are the individual contributors. They try to do the things, they try to manipulate the software according to their wishes, right? So this is not the right way to approach. Now, what is the challenge that they are able to face? Let's take an example. I'll give a task, and there are a few people who started creating the files. This is the existing way that you do. Somebody, I give the file, they created their file. They started realizing, oh, kuch sir ne to task diya tha, usme missing reh gaya. Unhone ek aur nahi file bana di. Other people keep on putting down this file. Now, if I have to see the consolidated view as a manager, do you think this is going to be the right way? Yogesh, do you agree? Do you think that this is right?
I don't think so.
Yes, definitely it is not. Because I can't read 50 files and consolidated view nahi nikal sakta because the same task was assigned to everyone. Here, yes, version system. So, what are the challenges? So, Yogesh, Arup, Manish, or anyone out there, do you want to discuss anything? That what is the challenge in this problem? Yeah, kya dikkat hai? वैसे एक directory के अंदर मैं सब कुछ अपना अपना सब लोग डाल रहे हैं ना?
कि हर एक जो member इस directory का वो एक ही file बना रहा है बार-बार. तो उसको जब merge करोगे तो उसमें आपके पास सब एक ही code होगा and एक ही code के अंदर add up होता रहेगा. तो आपको ये समझ में आएगा कौन सा code है और कौन सा code clear optimized नहीं है अपने software के लिए.
Right. Or anybody else who wants to take it on? What will be the challenge?
I guess एक point और होता है कि जो हमारा developer होगा जो जो project का सोचे चल रहा होगा उसको actually समझ नहीं आएगा कि problem कहाँ पे आती है. For example, जो आपने वो लिया था, मैंने एक question दिया है regarding this. तो उसके अंदर मेरा स्पेसिफिक ये है कि बेसिकली अगर डेवलपर के पास एक एरर आता है तो तीन बंदे सेम थिंग को एक फाइल में क्रिएट करके भेज रहे हैं
राइट
तो डेवलपर को कैसे पता चलेगा कि कौन सा में क्या प्रॉब्लम आ रही है. फॉर एग्जांपल एक डेवलपर के में एक प्रॉब्लम आ रहा है फॉर एग्जांपल 407 एरर
या
बट उसके रिगार्डिंग में उसको 50 वो आ चुकी है टिकट्स आ चुकी है तो उसको पूरा प्रॉपर एक्सप्लेन होगा नहीं कि हर एक टिकट को खोल-खोल के देखना पड़ेगा एंड
एक्सेसिबिलिटी हार्ड हो जाएगी. राइट और एनीबॉडी एल्स
मर्ज करने में
इशू आ जाएंगे. किसने कब ये चेंज बनाया आई एम नॉट एबल टू ट्रैक दैट अप. लेट्स से मैंने बोला कि रात को इसका कंपाइलेशन होना है अगली सुबह मैं देखता हूं एक और फाइल क्रिएट हो गई. Right, then who created this change? There are a lot of these questions, right? And I believe this picture which I took, I should have taken this with that like sad face. Ke bhai, ye mera kaam itna tough kyun ho raha hai? And this is exactly the challenge of version control system that is happening. So this is what the industry is adopting. The very simple method, the method one would be create a file, save karo, usme edit karo, fir wapis se save karo, repeat karte jao. There was another method, file karo, save karo, usi ke andar repeat kar do. Matlab, the second example which you just saw, that what you do is you create a file. If you are happy or with that file, you keep it. Otherwise, you create another version of it. Or else, you take that same file, you edit the change. Or else, if you have another person, you ask that, hey, these are the steps I have followed. Repeat for the same person again and again. Ultimately, my disk space is bhad rahi hai, kuch kaam ka kaam ho nahi pa raha hai. So what happened is these were the key question that everybody started asking that, hey, I'm not able to keep the track who is doing all these changes. How I can revert to the individual problem that have been asked because now I have to go to 50 files to revert every single change. Is it okay directly to change on the master code? Absolutely no. And that's where we come out with this beautiful concept called Git. Now, coming back to my question, who invented Git? Git kisne diya?
Linux to world.
It's our Linux to world.
Very good. Why he gave us this thing called Git? Usko kya aisi problem aa rahi hongi? Matlab ye challenges to definitely the hi uske paas. But aisi kya problem thi? Linus Torvald के पास जो उसने Git निकालने की सोची. Hey, I'm so sorry. I'm so many time I'm switching into Hindi. I hope everybody is okay with that bilingual approach.
No.
Yeah. is it fine that sometime I'm using Hindi in between?
No, I have no idea about Hindi, so I just know English. I wrote it in the chat.
I'm so sorry. I just realized right now that there might be some people who might be not able to understand Hindi. I hope that till the time whatever we have covered, you are able to get the cracks.
Yes.
Okay, I'll try to keep it like in my mind from right now, whatever the explanation is, I'm going to go. And I'll be happy to connect offline after this event. If you want to understand anything, I can repeat it for you. No problem on that side. Okay, now what I want to ask you is that what was the key reason that Linus Torvald came out with the concept of Git? Okay, let me help you. He's also trying to maintain some project, or he's trying to solve some of the challenges which he has got for maintaining his project. What was the other project that Linus Torvald has given to us apart from Git?
He started Linux, right?
So Linux, what is Linux?
Linux is also an operating system, if I'm not wrong.
Who is this?
What is this shoe?
So this is wrong. Linux is kernel. Now, kernel is that project which Linus Torvalds has given to us. Now, to maintain that kernel, he was facing these changes that, hey, he has made it open source. Anybody is coming and contributing to it. There were a lot of changes that he has to restrict, a lot of ideas he's not able to get. So what he came out with to solve this problem, he came out with a solution. Let's split it up. Now, what the split happens is, he created a master branch for himself that this is the code, I'm going to keep it. If you want to work, you create a sub branch out of it, which we typically call as the development phase. They keep it in the development. You keep on adding features to your development cycle. I'll keep on working my code by hearing your development things. Now, once your features are added to the development stage, I'll review it. Once the review is being done, I'll bring it to the release cycle. And when I'm going to release the new version, I'll pick these things from your release rather than taking from the development. Because development is something that is being targeted for you all as an individual contributor. Now, once the release is happening, it will again jump onto the master. Now, this is something that is being maintained by the project owner. So when it comes to GitHub, it was definitely given by Linus Torvald. What the challenge he was getting while maintaining the Linux the kernel code, he was getting a lot of these challenges. Because if somebody pull down a request and he tried to merge in this master, every single code can be spoiled up. And it is very easy, very hard to keep the track. So what he gave us the concept of Git, you clone the project, start adding your features. I'll review these things to you. Once I review, I'll come on to a release phase that, okay, I'll test it up. The minor upgrades I'll keep on doing because this is the project that I am driving. You are giving the idea. You gave the idea. I'll take the ideas from release and then I'll release into the major version, which you can again pull it up. Now, the best part is you are already having the clone. Now, you will get only pull the rest of part of it. Means, let's say I have downloaded a 1 GB of code. The new code states to be 1.2 GB. Now, rather than downloading 1.2 GB, now I have to just pull 200 MB, which is extra. So this is how the entire problem of the industry is getting sorted. The best part is, if I am working at my home and I have pushed down some of the changes, and if you want to bring all the changes, you just put down a command called pull, or in the case of Git, it's called Git pull, and automatically your environment will accept all the changes that have been doing into that master thing. So that was the very quick way to resolve all the changes. I can creep the track. I can make the life accessibility easy. I can easily contribute that who is contributing. I can give the credits, and moreover, I can maintain the project with the ease itself. So Git was the problem that was started. It is very easy to contribute. GitHub can be easily accessible via a graphical portal. It can be configured on Linux platform or Mac or on the Windows. More important, this is how the Git works. Like contributing to Git, either you can create your own repo or else you can contribute to somebody else's repo. It is always recommended that when you're trying to contribute to somebody else's repo, fork the repo. And when I say fork, easy way or a layman term, clone that repo. Means don't directly start pulling requests to the master branch. Create a copy of it, test it up, submit a PR request, and they can review that. While referencing to the PR request, provide as much as info that you wish to. Now, if you are contributing to your own project, it can be a local repository or create it in a GitHub repository. Means you can create that repo which you have created on GitHub as a private or as a public. It is highly recommend to keep it on public. Why I'm saying, because somebody else can keep on tracing your activities, that how consistent you are to the open source world. And when it comes to the participation, let's say you want to contribute to, you want to participate in Google Summer of Code or all the open source projects that I have just, or a contest that I have mentioned to you. If you want to contribute, being a project manager, I will review your GitHub, that how active you are towards the community. Why? Because when it come to the community, people see advantage. And when I say advantage, mean lucrative bonuses. Now, bonuses can be in terms of money. Like Google Summer of Code used to give 3.5 lakhs. That is definitely a huge amount. But that's money is the only priority thing that you can get it. As a project maintainer, it is absolutely no. So we want to see the consistency. Some people, what does it wrong is, if in the March, the project lines are getting opened, people will put down all their projects in February. That is not correct. You have to be consistent throughout the year, throughout your consistent way. Like even you can contribute one day of the week, just contribute. And that's where these green dots will create a pattern out there that, hey, this person is actively contributing to the society. And I'm keen interested to see those contribution. And that's where you make your public. If you want to keep it private, it's also a wonderful way to keep it your things private, because most of the industry does in that way. But yes, it totally depends on you, how you want to do it. A study from GitHub says that 35% people create their own repo and share it to the outside world, while 65% people clone the others and start contributing. So it's never too late to get started. Whenever you wish to fork a repo or create your own repo, share it to the other worlds, be a project maintainer, be a guide, and start getting into it. Now, while you are working on Git, there are again certain etiquettes that you need to follow. From because Git plays a very important role. Now, the very important tips are always fork the projects to want to contribute to, clone that project, create a pull request instead of directly pushing it to master branch. What happens is, what is the difference between this pull request and directly pushing is, when you clone the Git, you have an opportunity to Git push the things. Now, when you do the Git push, it automatically pushes to that branch. Or if you haven't cloned that branch, it is directly going to get reflect on the master part. And when I say master, this is my main drive. So what you should always do is create a pull request. Now, what is going to happen when you do a pull request? The project maintainer has the authority that, okay, this is something that somebody has requested for. And if it is sounding correct to me, because I am the responsible for maintaining the code, if it is good, he will merge or she will merge to it and saying a thank that, hey, this is something that is being accepted and merged. And that's where you get the credits. Third point is adding labels to the issues. I just talked about the beginner friendly issues. There where you can find down these labels that if you are interested in DSA, if you are interested in C, if you are interested in JavaScript, Java, XYZ, these labels will help you to quickly search the things, because GitHub give you a dashboard or a UI where you can do it. So this is very much important to label it, because if somebody is interested in looking your specific project, you should able to do it. Always title it very, very easy title so that everybody can understand. Don't use the mix match names or some traditional cool names out there. It should make sense so that anybody is there to interested in reading the description. Also, address the issue ID in the pull request. So whenever you make a pull request, you should also have that issue ID. Keep the message out there. So make sure that you keep on giving these information. More important point is, if someone is already working on the project, wait for 15 days of inactivity. Now, what happens is, as soon as you submit a PR, or when I say PR, it means the pull request, somebody might take up to 15 days, and it is of GitHub that it hard maximum to maximum it takes 15 days to resolve it, or at least somebody address it. So again, the same part of open source etiquette is be cooperative and collaborative. Be patient, be empathetic that somebody else is going to revert. After 10, 15 days, just put down a reminder that, hey, did somebody find out some time to look into this issue, which I have submitted. If somebody's not, try to reach out to some other channels or put down an email quoting the same, and slowly and gradually you can easily get the things. Moreover, whenever you are done with that request, create a documentation so somebody else can be helped on the same. So this is the way that how you should follow the Git etiquettes also. Now, if you want to be an active contributor, you want to accept the Git's part. The most important part is this Sheryl Sandberg's quote says, motivation comes from working on the things we care about. It also comes from the working the people we are caring about. Now, as I said, open source is all about collaboration with the like-minded people. Don't go and contribute to every project. For the sake of participating in programs like Google Summer of Code, don't participate. Might somebody else more passionate than you can get the opportunity. If you think, don't apply to all the projects that are listed. If you are happens to be a Java expert, try to label that projects which are entitled with Java and apply onto that only. Don't try to apply for Python projects or the projects which are beyond your control. So always try to understand this part, that people see these things also, that where you are coming from or what you are trying to achieve. So don't try and open the door for every opportunity that is knocking you. It should be your decision to take it. Why is, when people are financially investing into your things, they want some return. But in this open source world, when people are emotionally invested because you are not forcing someone to contribute, they want to contribute to learn something. And when it comes to learning, you should be open, you should be honest to the work that you want to do. So whenever you want to be an open source activist, or you want to be an active open source enthusiast, or you want to be an active on open source contributor, make sure that you are open, you are like empathetic, you are collaborative, and more importantly, you motivate others to get started. Now, if you have heard some of the keywords that you're not knowing into the entire webinar, just go and put it on Google. Try to connect with me and I can help you in connecting with the right resources if I don't know. There are a whole bunch of resources. There are like a whole bunch of resources available over the internet, over the cloud, that can unlock the true potential within you. You have to just type it. Now, more important, always remember collaboration always, competition never. And what I have always been like heard, and this is what the Gaurav Sharma, who is just talking to you. I'm a Linux lover, and I'm proudly says that I'm an open source enthusiast. I'm a tech speaker for many national and international conferences. Having an industry experience, you can say moreover like 3+ years. As of now, the current role signifies that I'm a solution architect at Red Hat, where my job role is to the pre-sales, means talking about the sales people to help them to understand the technical terms. I'm also a Red Hat certified architect with level 17. That includes 24 different certificates from Red Hat. I'm a Red Hat certified instructor and examiner. I have also cracked the other public cloud providers like AWS, Azure, Google. More important, the last two things I'm proud for, that in 2013, I fall in love with Linux. And since then, I haven't used Windows. I don't know coding language at all. I mean, C, C++, DSA, Java, Python, XYZ, I don't know at all. So something, just a brief about me. And if you wish to connect with me offline, I also run a YouTube channel with the name Cheers with Gaurav. And if you want to reach out to me on social media handles for LinkedIn and Twitter, it's RSCA Sharma. You can easily reach out to me and I can help you with all the queries that I won't be able to take it in the Q&A session. Before I jump onto the Q&A, I just want to say and reiterate my word that you don't need a title to lead, because title of a leader is about the actions that he takes or she takes. It's not about the position to claim yourself to be in a leader position. It's all about the decisions, the actions that you take. So you don't need a title to be a leader. just be an individual contributor in the open source world. I again want to thank the Creators Garage team for inviting me and giving me this opportunity. I hope I can pass on some of the learnings that I have learned during the industry part. So I hope that is fine.
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir.
Yeah, Yogesh. Thank you.
Your time. It was a great presentation and you have identified those issues very good and mostly linked all the doubts, but still we are now open for the question from the audience. So feel free to ask any queries. You can put them on down in the chat box and we will be taking them. Two questions. So
yeah, we can take that up. Okay. So the very first question is from Pramneet. Will how to use GitHub and produce project will be discussed or only the open source? So I have just given this, Praneet, the crux of it, that how you can do. What I can suggest you is just go to github.com. It is a very simple UI to create your account. Create the account over there. And after that, what you can do is just simply sign it up. Fork a project, clone. There are simple commands that are also given out there. You just go search it up and you just simply get it up. That's the very way. And also just connect me offline and I can share you some of the resources where you can get started. Or even what I'll do, give me a day's time. I can reach out to Creators Garage team. You have your email addresses. They can shoot down some of the learning resources to you and we can help you in resolving that part also. Then Munish has this question. What kind of info I have to share with the developer if we got an error? Let's assume I'm getting an error while opening a calculator. So Munish, I would say, first of all, your process, that what is the steps that you have used? Like, this is the step that you have used to basically adopt the things, or I should say, when you are trying to resolve that bug or you're testing that product, what are the steps that you have taken? If it is also good, if you are able to take the screenshot of it, you take the screenshots, you share those errors. Also, if you have tried certain things or experiment to try to resolve those errors, you should also present them. Format, I always recommend to put it down in a pointers, because that helps me in understanding that what was the flow that you have taken. So that's the way. Yeah, Manish.
Regarding that question, I have asked that because in home, I have seen like people are trying to send their processor's name, processor ID, for example, how number of tasks are in a parallel running, or how many tabs are open in a, for example, in a browser. So I was just confused, do we have to send this information, or do we particularly have to send information, for example, what is the error and and how we get the error. For example, just by clicking on it and it's from my show me the error. So that's something I can't understand.
So it totally depends on case to case basis, Manish. What happens is that when I am as a developer, if you ask me if it is an ongoing project which is already established, I would definitely here to see the challenges that you are getting. If it is in a phase mode of creating, you can always reach out that, hey, I am experiencing this issue. Is there somebody else who is getting the same? Ask for that. So acknowledgement will help you to understanding, or I would say getting the idea better.
Okay, and for example, I have Ubuntu. Okay, so Ubuntu, there's like two sets of software which we just test for like not developed yet. And they are, for example, you can open a software, but they are not optimized basically. So they say like you have this kind of problem. This format.
Sorry, I'm losing you, Manish. Means I'm not able to hear for sure. There is a lot of disturbance and I cannot hear anything. Is it only for me or Yogesh, Arup, can you please guys help over here?
No issues. Manish, you can write your question in the chat. That would be easy.
Yeah, because I'm not able to hear the things. So guys, anybody else? I cannot see much more questions. Feedback links are there. Definitely, guys, feel free to put down the genuine feedback. I'll be more than happy to hear if something went good or something went bad for you. Please let us know.
So if anyone is having any questions, let it come. Okay, we have a question in the chat.
How I can stop others using my program? Don't make it public. Just simply keep it private, Lakshita. I hope that is a very simple answer to that. But yeah, that is the hard truth. If you're not going to share it, somebody else, how it is going to use it? So yeah. Means I would say in that way only. I don't know. If you are, if you try to, if you want something more detailed, I want some more details from your side for sure. Yeah, Nirud.
Yeah. What we have to put in documentation?
Steps that you have followed, the very first part. That let's say the very first part is when you want to go ahead with the documentation, you have adopted certain steps. So I am telling about the reports or like the bug fixes that you want to do. So very first thing is you just go and start talking about that these are the steps I have followed and I'm not able to get the functionality correct, or this is the experience that I had. Can you help me in understanding XYZ? Or else, if you're trying to write the documentation, if your question is it in that way, understand the very basic example that if somebody else want to go at this document, you should be a very layman part. What, why, when, how, all these things should be covered. If you want to give some reference, make sure they are the public reference. When I say public reference means it should be accessible by the like public anywhere. Like I cannot go ahead and give you the link that are being accessed on access.redhat.com. It should be very much simple that is there. So that is how it should. I am here. I was all speaking on mute. I'm so sorry. So if you wish to connect with me, do reach out to me on social media handles. And thank you so much once again, guys, the Creators Garage team, for helping me in doing this. Thank you.
Thank you, Gaurav. It was great having you again. And yeah, I'm dropping the email address of Creators Garage. Anybody wants to reach out to us for anything related to this stuff, we'll be happy to help you out. So it will be there in the link box. And thank you, audience, for joining us. Thank you, everyone.
Thank you.
Can we leave now?
Feel free to leave.